Where were you?
Oh, I'm so worried.
Reception area.
Be right back.
That's okay, we're finished for the night.
Time flies when you're having fun.
What was that?
I say time flies when you're having fun.
He always says it's important. All right, give me the number.
Here you go, I forgot to print.
Thank you.
Thank you. Simon Davenport, please. Tell him it's Harry Calder.
Make
Excuse me, Mr. Davenport. Hey, Mr. Calder on the phone for you.
Harry, I'm sorry to bother you.
Then don't.
Why do you talk to me like that?
Because I don't like your sign.
Tonight I may return the favor.
Is Usherview Park in your jurisdiction?
You know it. Why?
When was the last time a field inspector from the Southridge office checked out the rides?
2 months ago.
Are you sure?
I did it myself.
That's unfortunate. Did you inspect the roller coaster?
Of course I inspected the roller coaster. What happened?
It just collapsed.
Jesus.
People are dead. I want you to go out there and represent the department. Find out if there was negligence involved.
You go.
It happens to be my wedding anniversary.
So take your wife.
You're funny, Harry. And we both know how much I admire your sense of teamwork. I didn't inspect that park. You did.
Keep that in mind on your way out there.
You all right? Chilly out here. Why don't you go inside? Did you see it?
How do you think it happened?
Doesn't make sense. Better go home and get some sleep.
Wayne was up there. He was walking the track. Anything wrong? He would have found it.
Who's Wayne?
I've been here 40 years. Nothing that ever happened before.
Jesus, Harry, you know the rocket, 54 years and not a single accident. It's the safest ride in the whole damn park.
Until tonight.
Tell me about it. Oh, Harry, Lieutenant Kiefer.
Hi.
Mrs. George Sperling, Golden Pacific Insurance. Harry's been standing to see.
How are you?
Your department inspect this place?
Every 3 months.
So, what the hell happened?
Good question.
I still can't believe it. We pay a higher insurance premium on the merry-go-round.
Come on, anybody have any ideas? You're the experts. Now, if it was a malfunction...
No way. Last month we had both trains x-rayed for metal fatigue. Clean bill of health.
Who are you?
Wayne Moore, head of mechanics.
Something might have happened after the test.
I walk that track every day myself.
Including today?
Including today. One solid hour from 7 to 8.
It's an act of God. When you put it back together, we'll send some stress engineers down and take a look.
We want coffee?
Black, please.
Bert, you opened a note, don't you?
Mm-hmm. I met a guy,
full-time out there. Carries a broom?
Yeah, that's Benny Nielsen.
What time does he get to work?
Yeah, look, everyone is in by 10.
He said he saw Wayne up on the roller coaster.
So?
So if Wayne inspects between 7 and 8, what was he doing up there 2 hours later?
Hey, Wayne, will you open the tracks at 10 this morning?
Hell no, I was home having breakfast.
You finished at 8?
8, maybe 8:15?
Nice.
That doesn't mean anything.
What is it?
It's like we carry Benny because he's been around since the place opened, but half the time he isn't sure whether it's day or night.
He drinks?
No. But he's an old man. Spends a lot of time talking to his wife.
When she died?
He was never married.
Forget I asked.
Come back and see us again.
I might. I'll lock your car in the cab.
kill us, at least let me put on some lip gloss.
Oh, I was thinking about the first cigarette I ever smoked. It was a Camel. No filter.
You just passed the house.
What?
The house. Remember where you used to live?
Oh, my God.
When you stop smoking, you're supposed to gain weight. That's the rule.
I think you look cute. For someone going through male menopause. Morning.
You ready?
Pam?
Fran. She's outside.
You've met Dale, haven't you?
No, I don't think so. Hi.
When did you bring her back?
Not late.
Your hair is different. You styling it?
No, it's a hot comb.
Hi, Dad.
Hi, Dylan.
Bye-bye. Have a good time.
Nice meeting you, Dale. How do you like the robe?
Just fine, thanks. Yours?
Birthday present. Hope you kept the bedroom door locked last night.
Of course, which is more than we used to do.
Oh, that's because there was nothing going on. Right. Most of them are still just babies. Well, it might be better if you wait till you get it home.
Helen, will you listen? Not a dog. Hamsters. I don't know if they're messy.
Look, it's your house. You decide.
No, I'm not trying to make you the heavy. Yeah, she seems like she likes them. Okay, fine. Sit down.
What do they eat? Hamster food.
And they like spinach, or carrots, or alfalfa.
Your mother says okay.
Oh, terrific. Can I have a pair?
Trouble is, they don't stay at pay. You can't dump wall-to-wall hamsters on your mother.
Okay. Can I have one right there?
Oh, the pretty one. Sure.
How are we going to get home?
Oh, we have some beautiful hamster castles.
I think maybe just a little box in here.
A little box? Why don't you put this paper in here?
What?
The newspaper here at the bottom of the cave.
Oh, I just put it in this corner. Here's
one. So it's today's paper?
Yeah, should be.
There was a fire on one of the dark rides. We put it out. No one was hurt. We've been instructed not to release any more information.
Look, we had an accident of our own last week. I just want to ask a few questions.
I'm sorry.
Who's putting the lid on this? The police?
I'd rather not say.
Oh, come on. What the hell is it? A state secret?
Management.
Who's management?
The Susquehanna Development Agreement. It's been a long day.
Who do I have to call? The chairman of the board?
He's in the book. Good night, Mr.
I thought Jesus said that.
Well, maybe he did, but according to that fortune cookie,
which is yours, by the way.
Confucius said it, too.
Don't believe everything you read.
Daddy's pissed off.
Where does she learn language like that?
Listen, I'm checking this morning. The park in Pittsburgh never had a problem. That's two accidents in 1 week.
Coincidence.
Maybe I'll give you another one.
I just talked to Bert Lyons out at Ocean View. All of a sudden, he's got orders not to be helpful.
They're trying to minimize publicity. Hold it, what's bugging you?
I'm not sure. You sending a man to Pittsburgh?
I'm on budget. We can't afford to send somebody out for lunch. Call it a week. You're sure about what you're not sure about. Call me back, okay?
Yeah, thanks.
Harry, you're called to Susquehanna Development. The president's name is Quinlan. He's on his way to Chicago, but if you want him, you can reach him at the Hyatt Regency later today.
Jackie?
Yeah?
Find out who owns Ocean View Park out here. Get the head man for me.
Okay.
Ocean View is run by the Leisure Time Corporation, based in Seattle.
You call the president?
Not available. He's on his way to Chicago.
Hyatt Regency.
Hyatt Regency.
What the hell do you mean you want to go to Chicago?
Five, Si. The presidents of five major corporations are on their way to the same hotel, including the owners of Ocean View and Wonderworld.
Maybe it's a convention. You think something's out of line, call the police or the city attorney.
The police and the city attorney didn't inspect that coaster. I did. Seems to me you rubbed my face in that.
You know, I was hoping your divorce would curb some of your more paranoid impulses.
I'm going to Chicago, Si. You're paying for the trip.
Out of the question.
Funny how things just pop into your mind.
I've been thinking about that medical building last year.
You bastard.
Shame about that roof caving in. I wish you hadn't pulled me off the inspection team. I'm pretty good at spotting substandard materials. It was your nephew's construction company, wasn't it?
How long will you be gone?
Day or two.
Better go home and get packed.
Thanks a lot.
Harry, you're a big disappointment to me.
I feel very badly about that, Si.
I mean it. You should have moved up in the department. District manager. Supervisor?
You know me, Si. Civil servant, no ambition.
It's your mouth. You have a real personality problem. You never want to fit in.
Depends on what you want fitted and where you want it put, Si. Well, up to Sylvia.
I'm sorry I couldn't be more specific on the phone, but I think you'll agree that a face-to-face meeting was necessary. This was delivered to me by mail yesterday. I was instructed to play this for you within a 24-hour period. That is why I told you it was an emergency.
Room service. I don't believe we ordered any.
Oh, sorry. Compliments of the hotel.
All right. Put it here.
That's all right. We can do that ourselves.
Oh.
Yes,
Mr. Quinlan?
Who are you?
Harry Corbett, Department of Standard and Safety.
I don't understand. This isn't Chicago jurisdiction.
No, sir. I just flew in this morning. I'd like to talk to you.
I'm sorry, Mr. Caller. I'm tight at the moment. If you leave your number at the desk.
Sorry, but I'm prepared to make a nuisance of myself.
I have two dimes. One for the police, one for the Tribune. Either you can invite me in, or else I can start making phone calls. I'm not your enemy, Mr. Quinlan. We may be on the same side.
Come in.
Gentlemen, this is Mr.
Caller.
Apparently, he wants to talk to us.
About what, Mr. Caller? About what you're doing here.
That's really none of your business.
Which one of you gentlemen runs the Leisure Development Corporation?
I do.
I was the field inspector on your coaster at Ocean View Park, sir. I don't think what happened there was an accident. Or your fire at Wonderworld, Mr. Penn.
When are we going to play that tape?
If you don't mind his presence?
Play it.
Your companies is involved either through wholly owned subsidiaries or long-term lease arrangement with the amusement park industry. As you know, it's a peculiar business, more vulnerable than most. During the past week, I've given you two examples of just how vulnerable. And I assure you I have no desire to create further incidents, assuming you agree to my proposal. The payment will be $1 million, to be delivered at a time and a place of my choosing. You'll be contacted no later than a week from today. You may or may not wish to bring in the police. That is entirely up to you. It will not hamper me in the slightest. Thank you for your time.
Jesus.
Polite son of a bitch, isn't he?
He can afford to be a million for starters. And no guarantee it stops there.
Well, we've heard the proposal. What do we do?
We pay. Can't have a bastard running around killing people.
Oh, good. Nice to have a humanitarian in the group.
All right. So it's not good for business either.
Thank you. You
yes,
realize.
The same. We gotta pay.
You mean price, gentlemen. Why bother the issue with morality?
Please.
Might be an idea to wait until he contacts us again. Could try and arrange a meeting.
Don't.
Why not?
Because you're amateur.
What the hell is he? The professional? A goddamn psychopath.
Whatever he is, he's smart.
We can do without the testimonials.
Just don't underestimate him. He's rigged two accidents in two parks 2,000 miles apart in 1 week without leaving a trace. That means a word. working knowledge of structural engineering, demolition, and probably electronics. You're not dealing with some nut with a bomb on a plane.
Well, it all comes down to the same thing. Extortion.
No argument.
Mr. Calder, what do you suggest?
Well, it's your money. And I'd get some expert advice if I were you. This is an interstate felony calling the federal authorities.
Send that tape in for voice analysis, and it was delivered to Quinlan to see if he kept the wrapping. The suspect talked about their gross earnings, correct?
Yes.
We're dealing with five public corporations. I want to know if anyone owns shares in all five, maybe reads the annual reports.
We'll get him.
Where are they? Suite 2308. All right, we'll take it from here. Mr. Calder, we want to thank you. Contacting us was the proper thing to do. I only wish more people would give us their trust.
Don't you want me to come upstairs?
No, that won't be necessary. I'm sure you want to be getting back home. Thanks again. You're with Standards and Safety, aren't you? Prepare a letter of commendation to the head of Mr. Calder's department. Have a nice flight.
Well, hello, Calder. I see you brought Donder and Blitzen. Let's talk.
You must be out of your mind.
It has to be you. He was very definite.
But why? I don't even know the crazy son of a bitch.
Apparently, he knows you.
And he wants me to deliver the money?
Yep. The drop is tomorrow, King's Dominion Park. You're to wait by a specified phone booth for his call.
Where is this place?
Richmond, Virginia.
Son of a bitch just called me.
What?
10 minutes ago, he said I deserved a vacation, that I'd like it in Virginia, then he hung up.
Calder, just, what is this relationship between you and our friend?
There isn't any relationship.
There has to be.
I said there isn't.
Then I assume you'd be, willing to take a polygraph test?
You know something, what you remind me of the man I work for. I don't like him either.
Really? Seemed nice enough to me.
You talked to him?
Sure. You had to have an official leave of absence. He was very cooperative.
I don't want an official leave of absence.
Yeah. That's what he said you'd say. Now listen. I don't know about you, but I want this man put away. At the moment, it's not wise to cross him. Your plane leaves in 3 hours.
I can always use another letter of commendation.
sweater with you. It's chilly tonight.
Look, you son of a bitch. I don't know why you're dragging me into this.
I trust you.
Bullshit. You don't even know me. You were the only one in that room who even had the slightest appreciation of what it is I'm doing.
What room? You bugged that hotel room, didn't you?
Of course. You told them not to underestimate me.
That was a good piece of advice.
Mister, get this straight. I said you're smart, but I'm not a fan, okay? You kill people.
Do you think they would have paid any attention if I had?
Is that what this is about, attention, for Christ's sake?
It's about money, Harry.
Then get a job.
I've had jobs. I'm not particularly productive at them.
I don't believe I'm having this conversation.
You're not very sympathetic, Harry.
And I'm trying to communicate with you.
Fine. Name a place, and we'll sit down and have a cup of coffee. I'm at my best over the phone.
What do you think of Poit?
Says he's gonna get you.
No one's gonna get me. But I'll promise you this, Harry. They pay me, and if they do what I say, I'll never bother them again.
Are you sure? Maybe you enjoy it.
Wrong psychological profile, Harry. I'm not in this for kicks.
Oh, yeah, I know. It's only the money. You're a businessman. And in a corrupt society, you're no worse than anybody else. We all cheat on our taxes. Detroit makes defective cars.
I'm not enjoying this conversation, Harry.
Then get yourself another messenger boy. Yes.
I may have made a mistake with you, Harry. We'll see. Go to Richmond and do as you're told.
Pierce, he'll behave himself.
Why did he pick a place like this?
Because it's noisy, it's crowded, and it's hell to cover. But we have one advantage.
What's that?
Caller.
Thanks a lot.
This is the telephone booth. We're instructed to have Caller waiting outside at 11:30 sharp. By the way, I want an out-of-order sign in that booth. Now, obviously, our friend will contact you by phone and tell you where to take the money. Do exactly what he says. It's in our best interest to expedite delivery.
Why?
Because somewhere, at some point, he has to get his hands on that money. It's his moment of maximum risk. There's no way he can avoid it. But whatever he does, we'll have our shot at him. If it's picked up by a third party, we follow. If he comes himself, we move in. We can't stake out the entire part, but we can cover you. And the money.
Don't you think he knows that?
Of course he does. He's made provisions. Where's the bag? That arrived yesterday. We're to fill it with unmarked bills, 50s and 100s. And Calder's to have it with him.
I don't follow.
He's protecting himself. We've gone over it in every way. Nothing unusual about it, except it's easy to spot.
A switch.
Very good, Calder.
Glad everybody understands. Would someone mind explaining
to me? You run Calder and us all over the park. And at one particular spot, he'll have a duplicate suitcase waiting.
He gets word to me to make a switch, and I walk off with the empty suitcase. Then while you're following me, he picks up the one with the money. Don't say very good.
So what do we do? He can tell Calder to make the switch in one of 1,000 places. How will we know?
Tom? Calder will be wearing that radio when he wants to alert us.
He just opens his mouth.
So what's gonna go wrong?
Everyone at the stations?
Yes, sir. I just ran a check. Pierce.
Do you read me?
10-4. All exits covered by security personnel.
Right.
Caller's mic open.
That's in breathing now. Phone booth?
We're tapped in.
Start the trace.
Start.
Yes?
Good morning, Harry. Sleep well?
Get on with it.
There's a stand near the Mason Dixon Music Hall. They sell hats. I want you to buy one. Have your name stitched on the brim. And then you'll like this, Harry. I want you to put it on.
Hey, Dan?
Just wait. You'll be contacted.
What stand was that, the Mason Dixon line?
Don't bother stalling, Harry. There isn't time to trace this call. Two other things. First, when you leave the toadstool, take off the microphone you're wearing.
What microphone?
Take it off, Harry. I'll be watching. I don't want you in voice contact with anyone. And if you have a second one, I'll know. Do you have a second one?
No, I don't.
You know something? I believe you, Harry.
Is that it?
I said there were two things. I have a little surprise for everybody. Are you listening, Mr. Hoyt? There's a bomb in the park. Please follow my instructions to the letter, or I'll be forced to set it off. I don't want your funny hat, Harry.
Any luck?
No.
Damn. What about the bomb? Is he lying?
I doubt it.
Go to the service gate and park that bomb van out of sight. Hey, Dominion, the hell I was there last week with my kid.
Take off your sunglasses.
Here you are, sir. Number 350. Don't get many Harrys around here. A lot of Jasons and Scotts.
What's he doing now?
Just standing there.
He has to tell Calder where to make the switch.
Well, how's he gonna do it? Skyrat?
Virge, anything to report from up there?
No, sir. Just about 30,000 cases of sunburn, but I'll keep my eyes open.
Thank you.
What did he look like?
I never even saw the guy. You can check with my boss, Red Line Delivery Service. Came in the mail with $100.
Written instructions?
No, he called us.
It's a radio, two-way. He's supposed to go to the Vertigo and turn it on.
When he starts broadcasting, can you pick him up?
Doubtful, sir. He'll probably use a banded frequency.
I'll try. Signal.
It's an illegal band. I can't scan it.
Well, keep at it.
My voice breaking up?
A little.
Adjust the squelch button.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Is that better?
Better! What next?
Get on the ride, please, Harry.
Hey, can't we simplify this?
Have to keep you moving. Sorry, Harry. Just try to enjoy yourself. Have a good time.
Thank you.
photograph, sir.
What photograph?
Ma'am, phone said take a picture of the man with the dark glasses on the roller coaster. That'll be $250.
Keep it.
I'll take that. What did the man say?
What?
The man who called. What exactly did he tell you to do?
Sorry, sir. I thought you were thinner. Go ahead and take the prize.
Do I have to?
No, sir. Don't you want me to get your aid?
No.
Okay, sir. Step right up here. I'll say you weigh 210 pounds. Go ahead and step right up on the scale, please.
Somebody's still moving.
He's on his way to the sky right now.
He's trying to wear us down.
He's doing a damn good job.
Ride?
As a matter of fact, this is almost the end of the line.
What do you want me to do?
First, Harry, I think I should tell you about the bomb. Would you like to know where it is?
Sure.
You're holding it.
You best.
Now, Harry, it was activated when you turned it on, so be very careful. I wouldn't want to lose you. And don't throw it, Harry. It will explode on impact. Don't try to open it. There's a tamper switch. And don't leave it behind. I want to see it in your hand when you get off. Okay, Harry. Now, do I have your full attention?
Screw you.
Hello to Yogi, hello to Lulu, hello to Scooby-Doo, Bonnie and Bradley.
Signal.
The signal that tells them you've switched suitcases.
I don't know what you're talking about.
Harry, I have the transmitter in my pocket. You know what happens if I push the button.
Damn it, how can I signal anybody? You made me take off the mic.
They gave you a backup. I'm watching. One more thing. If they don't move in immediately, I'll know you didn't get the signal. And that means I'll have to push the button. So please, Harry.
Just gave the signal.
Who's boarding?
What?
The car Calder got out of.
Who's getting in?
Sorry, sir. I wasn't watching for a second.
What's your name?
Lansing, sir.
One of yours. Pass me through to everybody.
Done, sir.
All units, converge on Skyway platform south side of park. Use extreme caution. Subject may be armed with explosives. Let's go.
See that car coming in? The red one?
Yes, sir.
Use the dock. Stop the machinery.
Get in this.
Don't argue. Clear the platform.
Come on.
Yes, clear it up the ride.
Get it down!
Yes.
Walk over to him.
Now. Hello. Hello.
You could have alerted us. Where the hell were your brain?
I was carrying a goddamn bomb.
Well, you weren't paralyzed. All you had to do was get a message to one of my men.
What, man? You pulled them all off me, you stupid son of a bitch. You were so hot to follow that suitcase.
I had you surrounded. Just one word. One move.
That's why he picked you. You can't think under pressure. Bring it in, boys.
Well?
It's plastic explosive and detonator cap rigged to go off by radio signal.
It's a beautiful piece of work.
Have it sent to Washington. We're going to make the components.
Won't do you much good, sir. You can buy them in any store.
You can't buy explosives in any store.
Well, no, sir, but this stuff is homemade.
Administration. Yeah. Maintenance vehicle leaving by the service exit.
Have it searched.
Give it a once-over.
Something funny called it?
You really think he doesn't have a way to get it out of you?
You know, I'm getting damn tired of your misplaced admiration.
Then drive me to the airport and put me on a plane.
Gladly. Make the arrangements.
Calder,
if your friend does get the money out, it just might be a terminal error.
Why? You marked that money, didn't you?
So what?
He said he wanted unmarked bills.
I don't give a damn what the bastard said.
It's done all the time, Mr. Calder. See, when he starts to pass the money, we get a geographic fix.
You know.
Not the way we've done it.
So I put my ass on the line for nothing. Why didn't you tell me?
It wasn't necessary.
I don't know who the hell I trust less. Him or you?
How can you be sure? Maybe you made a mistake.
Pixie dust, Harry. It's an old police trick. It shows up under ultraviolet light.
They didn't tell me.
I don't believe you, Harry.
I don't give a damn if you believe me or not. They didn't tell me.
Since they don't seem to take me seriously, I'll have to give them another demonstration.
Look, you proved your point, okay? You're smarter than they are. Let me make some calls. I'll get you your money.
I'm sorry, Harry, but that's not good business.
What's the sense of making innocent people suffer? Just give me some time. I promise they won't screw around with you.
It's too late for negotiations, Harry.
Listen to me.
You can tell your friends I'm about to give them another reminder of how vulnerable they are.
Who was that?
Operator.
Operator. What's the area code for Washington, D.C.?
202.
Would you like to get some coffee, please?
No,
I will not make you some coffee, please. Harry, what's going on?
5702. Special Agent Hoyt, please.
Who's this?
Harry Calder.
Harry Calder?
Right, it's urgent.
That's right, Snare. I'll be changing plans to Denver at 10:15.
Thank you.
She's finished.
Hmm?
Your daughter, remember her?
Oh.
Hey, where are you today?
Sorry, thank you.
I noticed.
You're scaring the horses.
That was terrific.
Thank you. Mm. Can we get something to eat?
Sure.
What do we have? What do you feel like?
Oh, I don't know, an enchilada?
An enchilada.
Have a chili.
Chili's fine.
Okay, okay.
Hey, listen. Why don't you two have yourself some ice cream? I have to make a phone call.
This is going to be a habit.
Tell you what. Next week, I'll take a few days off. We'll drive to San Diego. We can go to the zoo or we can go sailing.
Thomas?
If I don't, you can trade me in, okay? Get me one soon.
Okay.
This is Mr. Hoyt. You have a call for me?
Yes, sir.
Thank you.
Hello.
Hoyt, this is Calder. I gotta see you. I may have something important.
If you want me to miss my plane, May is not good enough.
May is all you got.
See you in my office.
For Christ's sake, don't tell me you had me come all the way out here for this.
First rise today, in 4 hours. TV coverage, a rock concert report.
Calder, we've checked it out. It's one of 3 dozen possibilities.
He's gonna hit it.
Oh, really? Now, that's very interesting. I don't suppose you happen to have anything in the way of proof.
I'm telling you, I know this guy. He loves machinery, and this is too tempting to pass up. He started with a roller coaster, so why not take out the biggest one of all?
Let me show you something. Complete breakdown for the summer. 4th of July event schedule. Rodeo at Wild West Park in Dallas. Enchanted Castle, opening the day at Funland in Wisconsin. Beauty contest at Sky's the Limit in Detroit.
Go ahead, read it.
Every fish fry in America doing it up for the 4th. Parades, air shows, belly dancers. There are at least 50 events on that list. And all of a sudden, you're down to one. That's quite a trick.
He's extorting 5 companies, right? They own less than a third of those parks, so we eliminate the others.
We've already tried that. Still too many to cover.
But how many are getting this kind of publicity? It's made to order for.
You're reaching.
Confucius say, with faith, man can move a mountain.
Where'd you get that? A fortune cookie?
All right. Try this office size. I just took these out of the files.
What are they?
Standard and safety permits for the Magic Mountain Coaster. It's in our jurisdiction. Read the name of the field inspector.
There,
under the authorization.
Approved H. Calder. You inspected it?
3 months ago. It's been in the back of my mind all morning, and those permits are public record. Anyone can look them up.
Now, wait a minute. Are you suggesting he's going to tear down that roller coaster just because you said it was safe?
I'm not his buddy anymore. He gets back at me and dumps on the rest of you with the same shot.
Come on, that's bargain basement Freud.
What have you got that's better? It's the perfect target on a perfect day.
Calder. You're asking me to make a total commitment of men and money on the basis of a hunch. No, I can't do it.
I'm sorry. I'll see you.
If you get any other ideas, let me know.
Sure.
Hello?
Me, listen, I'm going to be tied up for a while. Can you do me a favor and take Tracy home?
Yeah, I guess so. Where are you?
Look, I have to go out to Magic Mountain. It's business.
Magic Mountain.
Tell you about it tonight, okay?
Can we go?
Go where?
Magic Mountain?
I have the distinct impression that your father wouldn't want us there.
Well, it's something to do.
Get in.
I'm parked in a red zone.
If you're right about the day, we'll get it fixed. Come on.
Thank you.
lost you.
Oh, sorry, Mr. Demers. The valve's locked.
Had to get the key.
All right, that's all.
What do you think?
I'm an inspector, not an engineer.
So think like a bomber.
What momentum? Maximum speed. Probably coming off the loop. That's somewhere between here and here. If it's there at all.
I'll send the bomb squad out to warp the track.
Hold. We got a problem. If he's planted a bomb and he's watching, what happens if he sees them? As soon as they start to decommission it, he can blow them all over the park.
It's a point. Let's not take any chances. We'll clear everybody out, and then we'll make the search.
Over my dead body.
Hey, for all you know, this guy's 3,000 miles away in Coney Island.
And what if he isn't?
So he'll hit us tomorrow or the day after that. Unless you expect us to close down permanently.
Now, there may be a way to work this. Let's say he's here. Where would he be?
Who knows? Anywhere.
The ride doesn't start for over an hour, so why would he be hanging around the roller coaster? It only becomes important to him at 4 o'clock.
Meaning?
Meaning, if he isn't there, your men aren't in danger. Put him in maintenance clothes. Nobody will notice.
Still a risk.
Well, why don't you talk to him? If you're not willing, we'll forget about it.
Demers, dear.
All right, I'll see you next time.
Wait. What about that crowd?
What about
them? But they see a bunch of maintenance men on the tracks. They're gonna get nervous.
Got any bunting?
What?
Bunting, streamers, whatever the hell you use for decoration.
Yeah, we have miles of
it.
Why?
They could be wrapping it around the rails. It's the 4th of July, isn't it?
Always thinking.
So is he.
One of the hottest tracks in the country. Let's hear it for Sparks.
I'll check out the cars.
Mayor's on his way.
Well,
get him something.
This is Hoyt.
We checked out the car.
Nothing under the seats or the frame.
We'll regroup with the others.
Thanks. I think he is at Coney Island.
Can I bum a signal? I'm out.
Find anything?
No! In 5 minutes, we'll have to radio in. There won't be enough time.
He's not going out.
Yeah,
that's right. You're the photographer. Okay, everybody's
fine. Yeah.
way and see the world turn upside down. Special ticket holders, please assemble at the boarding platform.
Don't be cowards, folks. You only live once.
I'll be back in a few minutes.
Where to now? No, let's go on the roller coaster.
You never get on.
Oh, I'm still asleep.
Okay.
Same device he used in Richmond.
Gentlemen, you've earned our thanks. With your permission, I'd like to send letters of commendation to your chief.
Well, any suggestions?
What can we do? We know what he sounds like, but we don't know what he looks like. It's a young voice, can't be more than 30. So if we eliminate women, old men, and kids...
You're still left with 10,000 suspects.
Listen, I gotta get out of here. Will somebody make a decision?
About what?
Do we go or don't we?
Nothing in the cars. Can't possibly know we've found it. I think we're safe, at least for today.
Is that a yes or no?
That's a yes. Suspicious behavior. You'll be carrying a miniaturized transmitter. When the coaster starts its run, watch the crowd. He thinks his bomb is still in place. He'll try to set it off.
Where are you going?
Fresh air, it's like a sauna.
Watch everyone.
Thank you.
$100? You gotta be crazy.
I don't wanna go.
Listen, baby, $100 is $100.
I have to take you with me. I only need one ticket.
Yeah, sure. Go ahead. I'll wait for you here. It's a view.
Thank you.
You gonna miss the first ride, man?
Yep.
It's crazy.
You don't have to worry about it. Dad! I don't think it's worth it.
What the hell are you two doing here?
Having fun. You wanna join?
Fran, take Tracy and get out of here. This is not the place to be right now.
Harry, does this have anything to do with those phone calls?
Yes, now please take her home. We can all come back next week, okay?
Maybe the lawn will be shorter. Oh, you're gonna miss it. It's terrific.
You can tell your grandchildren you were the first ride on the Great American Revolution and live to tell about it. How would you compare it to other rides?
I think it will get a lot of attention.
So what's it been like?
Well, I didn't ride it, she wrote.
You look white as a sheet.
Play that back.
What?
The guy you were just into.
Who are you?
Play it back.
Sir, I'm a reporter. How'd you like to ride? Sir? It was fine. Just fine. You can tell your grandchildren you were the first ride on the Great American Revolution and live to tell about it. How would you compare it to other rides? I think it will get a lot of attention.
Christ's sake, close in. Put me through audience.
Right. Okay.
Excuse me.
What the?
That's him. He just got off the coast. Tell Hoyt.
He's on the first run.
Could have planned it.
Call him. Tell him to stop. Clear out the passage.
Oh, I feel like I'm on top of the world. Oh,
look this damn thing over. See if you can find the frequency was used.
Right. They're over the lift. It's too late to stop him now.
Don't come any closer.
It's a detonator. Hold your fire.
The bomb is in one of those cars.
He's got a transmitter. Damn it, put those guns away. If you shoot, we can still push the button.
Suppose he's bluffing.
Harry, tell them I don't bluff.
Put him down!
Now, have them clear me a path. Quickly!
If he's using the same trigger frequency, I think I can jam it.
Then what the hell are you waiting for? Go!
Now what do you want me to do?
Now, Harry, get me a gun.
You heard him!
Go with him.
Now listen, it's not gonna work. When the ride's over, you won't have anything to bargain.
Harry, you still don't understand. You'll be my leverage. If they don't let me out, I'll kill you.
Come on.
Harry, the gun.
Okay.